Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Here are 10 new things to try after you upgrade to macOS Monterey. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So macOS Monterey includes tons of new features. Here are 10 things to try out right away. First, there's focus. Instead of do not disturb on or off, you can now set all these different modes and customize do not disturb to meet your needs. To set these up, go to System Preferences, Notifications, and Focus. Then in there, go to Focus, and now you can create these different modes. Just use this plus button here, create a mode, and then for each mode here, you could add people or apps that can contact you even when you're in that mode. You could also have ways to have it turned on automatically, like when you're using an app or perhaps at a specific time or location. Once you've set up focus, you can go into Control Center and then you can click here and then choose a focus mode to go to. Notes has a new feature called Quick Notes. You can trigger it using either the FN key and Q, or on newer Macs it's a globe key and Q. And you can also go to the bottom right hand corner and you get this little square here. Click that and it will open up the Notes app and instantly give you access to this little note here. If you click the Link button, it allows you to add a link to the page that you were at. Quick Notes appear separately here at the top, but at any time you want, you can drag them into the regular categories here to make it a normal note. Another new feature of Notes is tags. You can now add any tag to any note anywhere in the note with the hash or pound symbol and type whatever you want. That instantly becomes a tag. You'll see them listed here and you can click on a tag to see only the notes with that tag in it. It's easy to add and remove tags and use them any way you want to help you organize your notes. Photos app has something called Live Text, which allows you to select text in a photo and you can copy that text and paste it into a document, or you can control click the text and have it translate the text or have it speak the text to you. This works in more places than just photos. You can use it on an image in Preview, you can use it on some images in Safari, and you can also use it in Mail when you get an image. There's also a system-wide translation feature. This works in just about any app. So here I am in Safari, for instance, and I can select some text and then Control-click it, two-finger-click on a trackpad, right-click on a mouse, choose Translate, and you could choose the language and you could have it speak the original, you could have it speak the translation, and you can have it copy the translation. You can also have it paste the translation in if you're in an editing app. So if you want to translate something while on TextEdit or Pages, you can. In System Preferences, there's a new preference pane for passwords. And this gives you the same features that you find in Safari. So you can access your passwords here rather than having to launch Safari. You can also use this function here, which allows you to export passwords and save them. It's a way to back up your passwords. In System Preferences in Apple ID, you can go to Hide My Email. And this is a feature where you can create fake email addresses that will forward to you so you can give them out when you're signing up for things and you don't trust that service with your actual email address. Now, one of the things I don't like about full screen mode for apps is that the menu bar is gone. You have to move your pointer all the way to the top for the menu bar to appear. But now you can turn the menu bar on for full screen apps. In System Preferences, go to Dock and Menu Bar. And there's an option here, turn this off. And now when you go into full screen mode, the menu bar will remain there. The Voice Memos app just became a lot easier to use. Now you can go to the settings here for each memo. You can not only set the speed, but you can also have it skip periods of silence. So you see these areas of silence, it's going to skip over those. It'll just jump over them, making it a lot easier to listen to long voice memos. So now your Mac can act as an AirPlay receiver. To turn this on, go to Sharing and then turn on AirPlay Receiver. Set it for just you, for anybody on the same network or anybody that can contact your Mac, and you can set a password if you want. Now with that turned on my iPhone, I can try something like, say, screen mirroring, and you'll see this Mac show up, and then I can select it and it will mirror after I accept it here and show on my Mac screen. So there's some things to try right away. I'm going to be taking a closer look at a lot of these in future videos, as well as a really big new feature of macOS Monterey, which is the new Shortcuts app, a new way to automate things on your Mac. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.